Hi, I'm Kevin Eikenberry, and I'm here to help you reach your potential as a leader and a human being. Welcome to Remarkable TV. Today we're talking about trust. Are you ready? Let's get started. A few months ago, I wrote a post about advice for leaders in 2018, and this is the third in a series of Remarkable TV episodes where I'm talking about those pieces of advice. In this episode, we're talking about the advice I gave in that post where I titled it as More Trust, Less Micromanagement. Now, speaking of my blog, I've also recently written a post titled Monitoring Success Without Micromanaging. And so today, there's a lot there about micromanagement, but today I want to very specifically talk about trust. So let's get started, shall we? First, trust is a noun. Yeah, trust is a thing. It's something that exists. You would say that in a conversation. There is trust here. Trust is a thing. And the dictionary tells us as well that trust is a noun. So trust is something, and it is something that is valuable, and it is something that we all treasure and want. And when we have it at work, things will go better, won't it? Okay, so, but trust is also a verb. Trust is a verb. It's a noun, it's a thing, and it's a verb. It's something that we do. I trust you, which means it's an action. And if it's action, that is super important to remember. Because if there's this thing that we value, it takes actions to make that valuable thing occur. And we can create more of the noun by doing the verb, which is really very cool, which leads me to my third point, which is someone has to start. Someone has to go first. So if you're thinking about a person that works with you or for you, and you're saying, well, I don't have the level of trust with them that I would like or that would be most valuable, then I'm saying to you, you're the leader, go first. Someone's got to start. Someone's got to do actions that show trust, that provide trust, that are trusting. Someone's got to go first. Now, let me ask you this question. If someone micromanages you, and I'm sure it's happened, just think of a time when you felt like you were being micromanaged. How did you feel? Did you feel like this is awesome and I can't wait for some more of that? Or did you feel like that person doesn't really trust me, or they aren't giving me a chance to show my worth or something like that? I'm guessing it's the latter. So it leads me to my final point today. Micromanaging less shows trust. So if you were listening to me earlier and said, okay, I got to start somewhere, Kevin, but I don't know really where to start, what I would say is let go a little bit. If you're micromanaging, one of the manifestations of that to the other person is they don't trust me. And if you want to build trust with folks, one of the ways that you can do that is by micromanaging less. Now remember that micromanaging is in the eye of the beholder. So if they feel like you are, guess what? You are. So keep that in mind. Now there's lots of other benefits that you can get from reducing the amount of micromanagement that you do. And my idea started with more trust and less micromanagement. There's lots more that we could talk about there. But today I just wanted to focus very specifically on trust and how if we're willing to be more trusting and if we're willing to let go just a little bit, that we will get more trust when we do less micromanagement. Let me close with today's tweet. Trust is both a noun and a verb. The more of the verb we do, the more of the noun we get. Every week, there's a podcast. Yes, you may have heard me say that before, but have you gone and listened as I talk to a leadership expert or a longtime successful leader talking about what it takes to lead more effectively, sharing their perspectives, stories, and experiences? Well, it's right there for you. The links are right here, the Remarkable Leadership Podcast, every week. Join me there. Take a listen. And every week right here, another episode of Remarkable TV, and I hope to see you next week.